So what he did was to make people take his coach. He promised them a safe trip. Don't worry about the pirates.
He basically lied.
He adopted a strategy. What was that? He resorted to? Bribery.
Bribery.
He resorted to bribery because he wanted to make the journey safe for his passengers. He promised them a safe trip, so he had to bribe the pirates. So he would leave wine, whiskey, food, all the goodies along the road so that the pirates would just pick them up, and the pirates promised not to disturb his coach. So his passengers would always be safe if they were to take a ride from him. Then later on, piracy was sort of... They became fat, right? They fed on his wine, whiskey, and food. And the thing is, other coachmen also copied this. Bribery is something which you can copy. So they saw Saladin do this, and it pleased the pirates. The pirates did not disturb him anymore. So they decided to do the same thing as well. So they also started to bribe the pirates. So in the end, the playing field was equal, right? Everybody could promise safe trips to their passengers. And of course, that's when the pirates became fat, and they were not too interested in their job anymore. So the journey became kind of safe. And the more coachmen started to join the profession. And it became a very competitive profession. So Saladin had to crack his head to think of a new strategy. How to get passengers to take his coach rather than other people's coaches. So he came up with this idea, and that is storytelling. Storytelling saved him. Because storytelling is not that easy to
copy.
It's not that easy to copy. It's tied very much to the storyteller. It's tied very much to the storytelling skill. So other people, we tried to tell stories, but they could not tell the story as well as Saladin could. And because of that, they lost out to him in terms of business. He could entertain his passengers with wonderful stories. So that was Saladin's gift. And he did a very clever thing. He did not just rely on his own identity stories, on his personal stories, on his signature stories. He decided to make use of OPS, other people's stories. So he would tell the passengers, okay, I tell you the story, now what story do you have to share with me? And in that way, he collected a lot more stories. And never ran short of stories. And I think this is something which we can learn from Saladin. Encourage people to tell you stories. Don't just tell stories, but encourage people to tell you stories. And then what you can do is, once the story is shared, it becomes yours. You can own that story. And you don't have to be so truthful as to tell the story as it was told to you. You can spice it up and then pass it on to another person. And this way, you will always have a fresh and inexhaustible supply of stories. Then we have better make use of storytelling as a tool to do different things. To reveal more about ourselves, to connect with others, to build trust, to share knowledge, to teach others.